Hello again, it's me, Kevin, from the YouTube science channel Vsauce2. What if I told you that in the 1800s, a single species of bird was believed to account for up to 40% of all winged creatures in North America? What if I told you you've never seen this bird before in your entire life? And you never will. The story of the passenger pigeon is a tragic tale, an age-old reminder that just because you can, doesn't mean you should. First things first, passenger pigeons are not carrier pigeons. They never delivered parcels, postcards, or dropped off acceptance letters to magic school.
You're a wizard, Henry.
Passenger pigeons were beautiful, elegant, more like doves than the common pigeon. Their name is actually derived from the French word passager, meaning passing by.
Bon voyage, little pigeon. We won't forget you.
In the early 1800s, their population peaked around 5 billion in North America. They migrated in flocks that were a mile wide and 300 miles long. If you lined them all up from beak to tail, it would wrap around the Earth 22 times. Which, as it turns out, only gets you a quarter of the way around Jupiter. Jupiter's big. But these large flocks proved to be a big problem for the passenger pigeon. It was this survival instinct that, ironically and sadly, led to their downfall. The Native American people of the Seneca tribe called the bird Jigawa, or Big Bread. For them, it was like a double-double small fries and a large shake, with wings. Hunters said it was easier than shooting fish in a barrel. A single shotgun blast could take out as many as 5 dozen birds. Mass hunts were known to bring down 50,000 pigeons a day, and quickly the population fell 5 billion to 1. By the time we got to 1910, there was only one passenger pigeon left, Martha.
Hey.
See, people didn't realize that this abundant food source wasn't gonna stay abundant forever. Once they did, all conservation efforts proved to be too little too late. When Martha died at her home in the Cincinnati Zoo, her body was put on ice and shipped to the Smithsonian. Today you can find her there, a solemn reminder of a species we took for granted.
Bon voyage, little pigeon. We won't forget you.
I know what you're thinking, Kevin. That was a long time ago. You couldn't make the same kind of mistake again. We're smarter now. Yeah, but are we?
Really?
Don't worry. We haven't slid into Martha territory quite yet. Just food for thought. That's time. Want more Martha? Click here to check artistic renditions brought to you by the Henry Ford and the Library of Virginia, proud partners of Google Arts and Culture. And make sure to subscribe to the Google Arts and Culture channel for a ton of great content by clicking here. See ya!